What is North Atlantic Oscillation? There are Azores High and Icelandic Low. Azores High is high atmospheric pressure and is typically found south of the Azores in the Atlantic Ocean. Icelandic Low is low atmospheric pressure and is located between Iceland and southern Greenland. The difference in air pressure between these two pressure areas significantly influences the strength and direction of westerly winds and location of storm tracks across the North Atlantic. The North Atlantic Oscillation has a decisive influence on the weather in Western Europe, with the effects being greatest in winter. When there is a large pressure difference between the high pressure area near the Azores and the low pressure area near Iceland, mild and moist ocean air is carried to Western Europe in winter. This leads to relatively mild winters with a lot of precipitation. The maritime climate is thus strengthened in this situation in Western Europe. If the differences between the low pressure area in Iceland and the high pressure area in the Azores are small, the ocean air will be transported more southerly towards Europe. Westerlies are weakened. Winds from the east and northeast are more frequent, bringing with them cold air. As a result, winters in Western Europe are drier and colder. The climate takes on a more continental character. In southern Europe, the weather is getting more turbulent as storms and precipitation formed over the ocean are now being channeled here. North Atlantic Oscillation gives indication of the most likely pressure set up over the winter period. It gives strong clues about the likely type of weather during a winter. The difference in air pressure between the high pressure area in the Azores and the low pressure area in Iceland is expressed with the NOW index. A large difference in air pressure between the two areas results in a positive NOW index and a small difference in a negative NOW index. For the low pressure area near Iceland, measurements from a station near Reykjavik are used. For the southern high pressure area, measurements at Lisbon are used. So, when the NOW is negative, there's a greater chance of a snowier winter. A good example is December 2010. There were 23 snow days in Belgium. A record. In most places there was between 20 and 25 centimeters of snow. There was even white Christmas, and it is rare in this country. The road salt had already run out before the real winter offensive started. The local roads as well as the main roads remained slippery and snowy for several days. Energy transition. The North Atlantic Oscillation also has an impact on the energy transition. Most countries in Europe are striving to replace fossil fuels with more renewable energy sources. Wind turbines and solar panels, which depend on the weather for energy generation, are commonly used means. There is the potential vulnerability of a European electricity grid that largely depends on wind and solar energy. Negative North Atlantic Oscillation can create conditions throughout Europe that make it impossible to generate sufficient energy with wind and sun. A negative NOW causes extra low winter temperatures in Western Europe, which increases energy demand. At the same time, with a negative NOW there is a weak wind, so that the yields from wind turbines are disappointing. Together with the short and dark winter days, the chance of Dunkelflaut increases. Dunkelflaut indicates a period in which little or no energy can be generated by means of wind and sunlight, because of simultaneously occurring darkness and calm. Because the NOW ensures corresponding weather conditions for several countries at the same time, disappointing electricity production cannot simply be imported from neighboring countries with the same problem. During a negative NOW, the wind force in southern Europe increases, but this coincides with increased cloud cover. As a result, the southern European countries need their wind energy to compensate for disappointing solar energy, and little can be exported. Hopefully you have learned something from the North Atlantic Oscillation.